Hello, Namaskar, and I welcome you all to Bank Exams Today. I welcome you to the session of data interpretation sets here. So we will solve DI questions here. दो तरह के DI करेंगे आज हम यहाँ पे. एक हम देखेंगे bar graph के ऊपर DI कैसे करते हैं, and then second हमारा case select DI. दोनों एक अच्छे level के DIs होंगे, so that will help in your upcoming exams. And this specialized for IBPS, RRB, Skill 2 GPO, and for other banking and insurance sector exams. And also, I would like to introduce you to the specialized batch that we have launched here for IBPS, RRB, Skill 2 GPO, and for Skill 3 as well. So this course will contain video classes for all the sections, and complete study material will be provided in the form of PDFs, along with the test series, which will contain 10 full-length tests. And also, there will be chapter-wise tests also, so that you can see which are your weaker areas, and you can analyze them, and you can later on improve those areas, right? And apart from that, a systematic study plan will also be provided, and interview preparation guidance for all those students who will clear the written exam. And one more information, that using this coupon code LK10, you can avail 10% discount as well. Clear? So let's just start with the session here and see the DI here. So the direction says, study the following bar chart carefully and answer the questions. Now bar chart, what is the bar chart showing? It is showing the number of students who have cleared the two examinations CAT and ZAT over the years per every 1,000 students. So this is the catch here. He is mentioning about the data given here is about per 1,000 students, not per 100. If it were per 100, it would be named as percentage, right? But it is per 1,000 students. Out of every 1,000 students, let's just say that out of every 1,000 students who appeared for CAT 2008, only 80 students passed. Out of every 1,000 students who appeared for ZAT exam, only 120 out of 1,000 will pass the exam in 2008. Clear? So instead, we can say that it is an alternate way, or you can say it also represents the percentage as well. Because like, if out of 1,000, only 80 will pass, then it means out of 100, only 8 will pass. So indirectly, he is giving you percentage only, but we will stick to this information only, that out of 1,000, only 80 will pass, and out of 1,000, only 120 will pass the exam. Similarly, different data is given for these two examinations for over the years, right? So we have understood what is the bar graph saying here, right? And now let's just move on to the questions. The question says, if the total number of students appeared in CAT in 2011 were 2,50,000, that is 2.5 lakhs, then how many of them had cleared the CAT examination in 2011? So he's saying that in CAT 2011, in reality, 2.5 lakh students appeared, right? But according to the graph, according to the bar graph, we see it says that out of every 1,000 students who will appear for CAT 2011, only 280 will pass the exam. So if there were only 1,000 students, 280 would have passed the exam. But there are now 2.5 lakh students who are appearing for CAT 2011. So it means this 2,50,000, right? It is 250 times 100. So similarly, the students will pass the exam, the number of students, that number of students which will pass the exam, it will be equal to 250 times 280, right? Proportionate change. So 250 times 280 means double 100 like this, and 25 into 28. So 25 into 8 is 200, and then 25 into 250 plus 20 is 70. So your answer is 70,000. Clear? Let's move on to the next one. The total number of students who have cleared both the examination in 2009 is approximately what percentage of total number of students who have cleared the examination, both examination together in 2012. Okay, so you need to find out the percentage only, that how many students, total students have passed both exam in 2009 over 2012. And one more thing is given here, the number of students who have applied in 2009, is 50% less than number of students who applied in 2012. So if I say in 2012, total 2x students applied for both the examination together, then in 2009, only x students together will apply for both the examinations in 2009, right? So in 2009, you say that for CAT, if 1,000 students appear, only 120 will pass. And for ZAT, if 1,000 students appear for exam, only 145 will pass. So in total, for 2,000 students appeared in CAT and ZAT together, only 265 will pass. But we are assuming that total number of X students have appeared for both the examination. So if out of 2000 only 265 will pass, then out of X, total students who will pass the examination will equal to 265 X over 2000, right? Similarly, in 2012, out of 2000, how many will pass? 150 plus 175. So that is equal to 50 plus 170, that is equal to 320, right? 320 plus 5, 325. So out of 2000, 325 will pass. So out of 2x, how many will pass? 325 over 2000 into 2x. Right? Now he's asking about the ratio of number of students who passed in 2009 over 2012. So in 2009, the number of students who passed the both the examination that was equal to 265x over 2000 and divided by 325 into 2x into here over 2000. So required ratio is equal to this. So in short, we can say that this 2000 and 2000 will cancel out each other, right? So and x will cancel out each other, so we will get half of 265 over 325, half of 265 over 325, right? This is the ratio. If we want to convert it into percentage, we will just multiply it by 100, right? We will just multiply it by 100. In the other words, we can just say, if we can find out 265 is how much percentage of 325 and that answer is divided by 2, then we will get the final answer, right? So let's just say that 100% of 325 is equal to 325 and 10% will be equal to 32.5. So if we multiply it by 8, so 80% will be equal to 8 times 32.5, that is equal to 8 into 5, 40. 8 into 2, 16 plus 4, 20 and 260. So 260. Similarly, 1% value, if 10% value is 32.5, 1% value will be equal to 3.25 and half percent will be equal to 1.675, something like this. So if you see 260 plus 3 is 263.25 plus 1, 264. So it is somewhat close to 265. So it means that 265 is equal to round about approximately 81.5% of 325. Okay. Approximately. So our answer will be equal to half of approximately 81.5%. And this approximation will give us 40.7% approximately final answer is. So the answer is 40.77%. Clear? So I hope you have understood the question here. Let's move on to the next one. The number of students who have cleared CAT examinations in 2010 is approximately what percentage more than number of students who have cleared ZAT examination in that year? So CAT 2010 over ZAT 2010. We just need to find out that ratio, then we can easily find out what number of students who cleared CAT 2010 is how much percent more than the ZAT in that year. Okay. So let's just say in CAT 2010, out of 1,000, 160 will pass the exam. And in ZAT 2010, out of 1,000, 90 will pass. So can we do like that, if we say that this percentage will be equal to 90 over 160, right? So approximately, if I see it is equal to 900 over 16, or you can say 450 over 8, so that will be equal to 56 point something, right? But you don't see any option here. Why? Let's see. The condition, the data given was based on a condition that you have to take assumption that if 1,000 students will appear for CAT examination in 2010, only 160 out of them. So this is a comparative data, not the exact data, not the absolute data. It is not the absolute data. It is not the real data. They are just saying that if 1,000 students will appear for CAT examination and 160 will appear, or you can say he is just telling you that only 16% of total students will pass the exam, or only 9% of students who will appear for that examination in 2000, only 9% of them will pass the exam. So this percentage data is only even, this is a comparative data, not absolute data. So how, if you don't know what how many total students appeared for CAT or ZAT, how can you find out how many 16% of total if you don't know the total, right? So it cannot be determined. If you can't find out the number of students who will pass the examination, then it cannot be determined that how much percentage one is more than the other. Clear? I hope you have understood this concept, right? Understood this thing. If you have any doubt, you can raise the doubt and it will be resolved. Okay, now let's just move on to the next one. So what is the respective ratio of total number of students who clear the CAT examination? CAT examination over the years. So over all the years, like in 2008, 9, 10, 11, 12, in total, how many students have cleared the CAT examination? And with respect to the ratio of, you have to find the ratio of that number to the number of students who cleared the ZAT examination over the year. And one more thing that is given is total number of students who applied for CAT is CAT examination over the years is 75% of total number of students applied for ZAT. So what he is trying to say, if we assume that total number of students who have applied in ZAT examination over all the years, they were 4x, then for CAT it will be equal to 3x, right? अब अगर हम ये देखें, अगर हम बार ग्राफ को देखें कि कैट में, अगर अगर हम कैट को देखें बार ग्राफ में, सो ओवर ऑल द इयर्स टोटल 5,000 चल रहे हैं, बिकॉज ग्राफ इज सेइंग दिस डेटा इज पर 1,000. सो इफ 1,000 स्टूडेंट्स अपीयर फॉर कैट 2008, ओनली 80 विल पास, राइट? सिमिलरली 1,000 फॉर 2009. So we can see out of 5,000 total appearing for CAT for all the years, how many of them will pass? 80 plus 120 plus 160 plus 280 plus 150, right? 000 and 5, 8, 13, 19, 21 and 8, 29, 2 to 4, 5, 6 and 7, 790 will pass. Similarly, for that, for all the years together, all out of 5,000, how many of them will pass? 120 plus 145, it is equal to 265 plus 90. That will be equal to 365 minus 10, that is 355 plus 80. So 355 plus 80, 435 plus 35 plus 500, 610. Only 610 will pass the examination. The 610 is equal to 120 plus 145 plus 90 plus 80 plus 175. Right? So only 610 will pass the examination. Now, this 790 is out of 5,000. So out of 5,000, if 790 pass the exam over all the years in CAT, out of 4x, how many of them will pass the exam? 790 over 5,000 into 4x. Similarly, out of 5,000 appearing in that examination over all the years, if 6-10 are passing the exam, then out of 3x, how many of them will pass the exam? 6-10 over 5,000 into 3x, right? If you want to take the ratio, this 5,000 will get cancelled out eventually, right? And this x will also get cancelled out, right? So you will get the ratio is the required ratio will be equal to 3x into 7, 3, the 790 into 4, is there an issue? 790 into 4, 3x. In CAT, there are 3x. 790 into 3x divided by 610 into 4x. Right? This x and will be cancelled out. And you can see the ratio 0 and 0 will also be cancelled out. 3 into 80 minus 1. So 240 minus 3, 237. 4 into 60 plus 1, 240 plus 4, 244. So this is your final answer. So required ratio will be equal to 237 over 244. Clear? Let's just move on to the next one. Find the total number of students who applied in 2012. If total number of students who applied in 2012 were 7.5 lakhs. Okay. And the respective ratio of number of students who applied for CAT. For CAT, how many students applied? And for ZAT, how many students applied? They were in ratio 7:8. And the total value is equal to 7.5 lakhs. So we can say that if we just assume that for CAT, 7x people applied in 2012, then for ZAT, 8x will apply in 2012. And in total, 15x will apply for both exams together, and this value will be equal to 7.5 lakhs as given in the statement. So x value of x will be equal to 0.5 lakhs, that is 50,000. Clear? Now, he says, find the total number of students who cleared CAT in 2012 and number of students who cleared ZAT. Right? So total number of students who have cleared the examination or who have cleared both the examination in 2012. Right? So I can just say that about CAT examination in 2012, out of 1000 only 150 will pass the exam. So out of 7x, how many will pass the exam? 150 over 1000 multiplied by 7x, right? Similarly, for ZAT examination, out of 1000 only 175 will pass the exam. So for 8x, how many of them will pass the examination? That will be equal to 175 over 1000 into 8x. So total, taking the summation of these, we will get the total number as 7x into 150 plus 8x into 175 over 1000, right? And this we can say it is equal to 1050 plus 8 into 175, that will be equal to 1600 minus 200, that is 1400x over 1000. So this is equal to 245 over 100x, right? Now the value of x is equal to 0.5 lakhs, that is 50,000. So 245 over 100 multiplied by 50,000. So that will be equal to 500 into 245. Right, so this is equal to 1225. Final value is 1225. So I hope you have understood this question. So कुछ इस तरह की DIs आती हैं जो थोड़ा बहुत calculative होती हैं. We just need to be focused on what is the statement saying and be clear about the statement, and we should stick to the concept and just keep our mind cool, right? चलिए next DI पे move करते हैं. It says a company acquired 4 teams of IPL named as Chennai, Punjab, Kolkata, and Rajasthan. They have invested some money and earned revenue by selling its tickets. Okay. So after completion of league, the results were like they had calculated specific data like expenses, revenue, profit and loss of the team for the year 2000 were summarized. The chairman of the company found out that the profit of Kolkata and Rajasthan are same. Profit for Kolkata and Rajasthan will be same. The revenue earned by the sale of Kolkata were same as that of Punjab. The profit of Kolkata and Rajasthan and revenue of Kolkata and Punjab. And profits of Chennai were 10.75% of revenue earned by its ticket sales. Okay, whereas the profit of Punjab were 20% of the revenue earned by its ticket sales. Now, up to this point, जो भी information given है वो सब percentage के terms में given है, right? हमें अभी तक कुछ भी absolute value नहीं मिला. We'll keep on moving. While the total expenses of Kolkata were 2.5 times its profit. ठीक है, कोलकाता का जो टोटल एक्सपेंसेस है. नाउ यू कैन डू वन थिंग, यू कैन जस्ट कीप ऑन राइटिंग डाउन द थिंग्स, लिस्टिंग डाउन द थिंग्स लाइक वी डू व्हाइल सॉल्विंग पजल्स इन रीजनिंग. क्योंकि देखो यहां पर तो मुझे सारा स्क्रीन पर दिख रहा है एक साथ, ठीक है, बट वहां पर आपको आपका पेज अलग होगा, आप स्क्रीन पर ऐसे नहीं लिख सकते हो, एनोटेट नहीं कर सकते हो, ठीक है. सो व्हाट यू शुड डू इज लाइक writing down each and everything. That profit of Kolkata is equal to profit of Rajasthan. Similarly, revenue earned by Kolkata is equal to revenue earned by Punjab, right? And profits of Chennai, it is equal to 10.5% of revenue. Obviously, revenue of Chennai itself. Whereas the profits of Punjab was 20% of the revenue of the Punjab itself. Right? The total expenses of Kolkata were 2.5 times its profits. 2.5 times its profits, right? So it is equal to 2.5 times the profit of Kolkata. And revenue earned by selling the tickets, improve it. Selling the ticket of Rajasthan were 1.5 times of its profits. So revenue by selling the tickets of Rajasthan were 1.5 times the profit earned by the team of Rajasthan. And now we have come to an absolute value. The total expenses of Kolkata were 12 million, right? So now we can start calculating everything. That expenses of Kolkata were 12 million, right? 12 million. And of Chennai, that total expenses of Chennai were 10% less than those of Kolkata. That means 90% of Kolkata. So expenses of Chennai will be equal to 90% of that. So it is equal to 90 over 100 of 12 million. So it is equal to 10.8 million. Right? So we can do one thing. We can just do this because it will be helpful while solving the questions. Now you see profits. Now we can start the profit of Chennai. Right. Profit of Chennai, because expenses of Chennai we do have. Profits of Chennai were 10.75% of revenue of Chennai. Right. Profit of Chennai will be equal to 10.7% of revenue. 10.7% of revenue of Chennai. Right. So profit, you know that it is equal to revenue minus expenses of Chennai is equal to 10.5% of revenue right? So it is, so in short, expenses of Chennai, will be equal to 100 minus 10.75, that will be equal to 89.25% of sales, right? Revenue minus expenses, or you can say 10.75% of revenue, or you can say revenue or sales, though those are all the same things, right? 10% of the revenue, right? So it will be equal to, expenses of Chennai, this will be equal to 10.8 billion is equal to 89.25%, 89.25% of revenue, or you can say sales, right? So sales will be equal to sales of Chennai. So what I'm trying to say here is sales of Chennai, is equal to 89.25%. So that will be around 12.1 million. Right? You can also mark it now. Right? Now let's move on to the next information that we can draw out. Similarly, I can say that profit of Chennai will be equal to 10.7% of revenue, that is sales. So 10.7% of or you can say 12.1, this is total sales, this is my minus expenses, 12.1 minus 10.8, so it will be equal to 1.3 million. So profit of Chennai will be equal to 1.3 million. Clear? Now we can see the profit of Kolkata. Let's just find out what is profit of Kolkata is equal to profit of Rajasthan. Okay. And the expenses of Kolkata will be equal to 2.5 times profits of Kolkata. Okay. So in short, I can say that profit of Kolkata will be equal to 12 divided by 2.5. That will be equal to 4.8 million. So we can also highlight it. Okay. Now profits of Kolkata we know. So that will be equal to sales minus expenses. Right. So we can just say that sales will be equal to profit plus expenses. So revenue of Kolkata will be equal to 4.8 plus 12. That will be equal to 16.8 million. Clear? Now let's just erase this thing. We can erase this again. Do some more calculation. Now, if you see the profit of Rajasthan, what it will be equal to? Profit of Rajasthan is equal to profit of Kolkata. So profit of Kolkata we have already found out. So profit of Rajasthan will be equal to 4.8 million only. Right? Similarly, if we say profit of Punjab, okay, revenue of Punjab and profit of Punjab. Okay, so the revenue of Punjab is also equal to revenue of Kolkata. So sales of Punjab is also equal to sales of Kolkata. So sales of Punjab is equal to sales of Kolkata, that is equal to 16.8 million. And also we know that profits earned by Punjab is 20% of its revenue, that is sales. So profit earned by Punjab will be equal to 1 upon 5 of total sales, that is 16.8, and it will be equal to 3.36 million, right? Similarly, sale, now if we want to find out what is the value of Rajasthan, Rajasthan. So sales of Rajasthan will be equal to 1.5 times the profit of Rajasthan, right? And profit of Rajasthan is equal to profit of Kolkata. So profit of Kolkata is equal to 4.8 million. So profit of Rajasthan will be equal to 4.8 million only. And revenue, that is sales of Rajasthan, will be equal to sales of Rajasthan will be equal to sales of Rajasthan will be equal to 1.5 times. So 4.8 multiplied by 1.5. 4.8 multiplied by 1.5. So that will be equal to 7.2 million. Clear? Now we have found out what is the value of profit earned by different teams and what is the value of sales or you can say revenue earned by all the teams. So we can just make a table here. We can just make a table here just for our ease that there are teams and there are sales, there are expenses and profit. We can easily find out. Right, so we'll just make a table. So this is a bit lengthy DI, but you just need to keep the patience and calculation करते रहिए जैसे इसे statement बोलता जाता है, so it will be a lot more easier then. Okay, so Chennai, Punjab, Kolkata, and Rajasthan. Chennai, Chennai, and the next is Punjab, and next is Kolkata, and the next one is Rajasthan. Clear? So we can see the value sales here. Chennai, Punjab, Kolkata, and Rajasthan. Chennai, Punjab, Kolkata, yeah, and that is equal to 12.1, 16.8, 16.8, and 7.2. Similarly, we can see expenses as well. Expenses of Chennai, 10.8. Okay, 10.8, 13.44. Punjab, yeah, we'll find out. 16.8, yeah, and 12 for Kolkata and for Rajasthan, it will be equal to 2.4. 2.4. Now we can find out the profit as well. It is equal to 1.3 here, 3.36 here, 4.8, and 4.8. These all values are in million. Now we can easily solve the question. So let's move towards the question. Profit of Rajasthan was what percentage of its sales? Profit of Rajasthan was what percentage of its sales? That is 4.8 divided by 4.8 divided by 7.2, and it will be equal to 6 over 9, that is 2 over 3, and 2 over 3 is equal to 66.67%. Okay. Next question. Profit gained by all the teams together, which was acquired by company, is what percentage of sales? So total profit over total sales. The total profit is 6 as it is, 8 at 16, 3, 19, 20, 2, 2, 1, 3, 3, 6, 4, 10, 4, 14.26. And total sales is equal to 9. 3 is 9, 15, 22. Okay, and 2, 1, 3, and 4, 52.9. Right, so 14.26 divided by 52.9. Okay, 52.9. So we have to find out how much percentage is 14.26 of 52.9. So if you just we can just simply write it as 1426 over 529. So it is, we can simply write it as 529 plus 897. 1426 minus 529, it will be equal to 897. 897 over 529. So this 529 is 100% of itself, right? 100% of 529. We just need to find out 897 is how much percentage of 529. So 100% of 529 will be equal to 529. Similarly, 10% will be equal to 52.9. 52.9. Okay? 52.9. It was 52.9. So it just, you can say, divided by 1. No. So in fact, we cannot do like this. Let's just say that 100%, how much 100% of 52.9 will be equal to 52.9. So 10% will be equal to 5.29, right? So if I multiply it by 3, then it will cross, because 3 into 5 15, so it will cross 14.26. let's just say that 20% will be equal to 10.58, right? 1% will be equal to 0.529. And similarly, I can say that 6% will be equal to 3.1. So 20 plus 6, 26% will be equal to 13 point something, right? So it will be closer to 14, right? So I can say that any value closer to 26 will be our answer. 26.96%. This is our answer. Clear? Let's move to the next question. If all of the four teams donate 20, 40, 10 and 50% respectively of their profit to a school, then what percentage of the profit, then donated money is what percentage of the profit? Okay, so we have to find out the donated money now. So let's just say, let's make another column of donated money. So first of all, 20% of 1.3, it will be equal to 1.5. That is 0.26. Then 40, then 10, then 50. And 40% will be equal to 3.36. So it will be equal to 1.34, right? And then 10% will be equal to 0.48, and 50% will be equal to 2.4. So total donated money is we can see that 4.48. So total donated money is 4.48 out of 14.26. 4.48 out of 14.26. You have to find out 4.8 is how much percentage of 14.26, right? Then again, we can see that 100% of 14.26 is equals to 14.26. Then 10% will be equal to 1.426, right? And now we can say that 30% will be equal to 3 times it, 4.728, right? And 1% will be equal to 0.1426. So if I see, it is something more than 31%, right? So this answer is 31.41%. Clear? Let's move on to the next one. Which team has highest efficiency? If the formula for the efficiency is like, how much profit do you gain per unit sale? Efficiency is profit divided by sale into 100. So you just need to find out profit over sale ratio, then multiply it by 100. Profit over sale. Okay. So we just do that. Profit 1.3 over say 12.1, right? And by 100, so 10% will be equal to 1.2, right? 1.2. So it is closer to 10, and then 0.1% will be equal to 0.12, and 7 will be equal to, okay, so it is equal to closer to 10.74. So this we have done for Chennai, and for Punjab we can clearly see that 3.36 multiplied by 5, it will be equal to somewhere closer to 16.8, and I'm correct, right? So your profit, your efficiency will be in this case will be equal to 20%. Okay, now for Kolkata, 4.8 divided by 16.8. So I can simply write it as 48/168. You can convert it into smaller fraction, right? And it will look like this, right? 2/7. 1/7 is 14.28. So 14.28 multiplied by 2, that will be equal to 28.56%, right? Similarly, if I see 4.8/7.2 for Rajasthan, it will be equal to 6/9, that is 2/3. So 2/3 will be equal to 66.66%, right? So we can clearly see the efficiency for Rajasthan is the highest. Clear? Now let's move on to the next one. Find the ratio of average sales of all teams to the average profit of all teams. So the total sales is 52.9 divided by 4. This is the average sales, right? The total sales is 52.9 divided by 4 is average sales. Now total profit is 14.26. Total profit is 14.26. 14.26/4, right? So it will be equal to 3.56, around like this, and it will be equal to 13.22, right? So the required ratio is 13.22 ratio 3.56. Clear? So this was the last question of the second day. So we will keep this session to this point only. And I hope आपको सारी चीजें सारे कंसेप्ट और जितनी कैलकुलेशंस का जो अप्रोच था वो समझ में आया है अच्छे से, right? If you have any query, you can raise it and it will be resolved for sure, right? So and if you want in detail, in depth analysis of if you want to practice more questions like this, right? और अच्छे से पढ़ना चाहते हैं ऐसे ही ऐसे टॉपिक्स पे, तो आप इस बैच को परचेज कर सकते हैं, right? So we last year we have so many success stories to tell. In the last few years, we had launched batches like this for IRLP scale 2 and for scale 3 as well. So these were students who have cleared that exam, right? Similarly, for other exams like Bank of India Credit Officer, Vijaya Bank Credit Officer, Bank of India Credit Officer, there are lots and lots of success stories to tell. Your face could be the next one in the upcoming sessions, right? So just don't just wait. You can avail the benefit as well of the डिस्काउंट, राइट? सो हम ये सेशन को अभी यहीं तक रखते हैं. नेक्स्ट सेशन में मिलते हैं नेक्स्ट डेज के साथ, नेक्स्ट कुछ अच्छे इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक के साथ. टिल देन टेक केयर, सी यू, बाय बाय, कीप स्टडी.